ladies are more than beautiful, of course. They have an indefinable, elusive quality, an attitude, a presence, a magic, the Linda Evangelista. Naomi Campbell and Christy Turlington strut their designer stuff. They are the supermodels of the 90s, and they're raking in millions for their clients and for themselves.
It's a place of invention in the clothes, and you end up just watching the girls all during the show.
That's very dangerous, though, isn't it?
Well, it's dangerous, except that these girls are such pros, and they're so beautiful that they really do make almost any outfit look good. So
for about the past 10 years, made a decision that it was so important to have the star print models in their shows that they were willing to pay their rates. And I think that there's a really significant...
Backstage, superstar glamour becomes a matter of hard work, professionalism, and sometimes a little help from your friends.
I always applaud at my friends. I think I know what it feels like on the other side, knowing that it feels nice to get it a clap. But and also I feel bad if they know that I'm there and I don't give them a clap. I feel like they'll feel bad. It's not necessarily for the clothes that I clap.
Yeah,
it's for them.
Yeah. So when you're on the runway, you like to hear applause set. It makes you feel.
Yeah.
It sort of
gives you a little energy to work for.
But all that adulation has a price. The price any star has to pay in catty gossip and negative reporting.
The Time magazine story, for example. It is something new culturally.
I didn't participate in the Time magazine interview. I didn't think it would be positive. Mm. Especially if they were out to get me, they're always out to get me.
Still, the final verdict belongs to the couturiers themselves, whose clothes have to wow potential customers. Fashion File and Tim Blanks, contributing editor of Toronto Life Fashion magazine.
I smile, chancellor, and if you don't know what feels up, I...